All right, so I'm clearly much younger than Lars here, but unfortunately I would say that my career as a gambler started very much the same as his with streak tips in Sweden. I also actually had a book on a boxing game when I was maybe 13 years old. Boxing was still a big sport. And it was a Swedish boxer called Lillen Eklund. He was boxing an English guy called Frank Bruno in a European championship fight. No one cares about that anymore. But at that point, it was a very big thing in Sweden. So I actually ran a book on the school for that match. And that was probably my first experience as a bookmaker. I kept on working in the finance industry for a few years after my studies. But in 2000, I started at Junibet. I think the drive for us has always been just to create the best possible sports book. I think not only me, but a few other guys you'll meet later on. We have been working tirelessly for more than a decade just to create the best possible sports betting experience. And that's probably, or that's definitely why Kambi exists today. Working at Unibet, we felt that we had no chance of getting the focus and the resources to create the best possible sports book. Therefore, in 2009, together with a lot of these people that we'll present later on, and of course, together with Anders Strom as well, created a business plan on how to create a B2B sports betting company to serve Unibet, but also to serve other companies. So I think we've come a long way on actually doing very close to a perfect sports book. It's still much, much more to do. But just looking on this year, we have won a few awards for creating the best sports book, both here in Europe and in US. And at the moment, we power 9 out of 50 companies on the EDR Power 50 list, which are, especially here in Europe, meant to be the largest gaming operators in Europe. Of course, the sports betting industry are globalization now, with the US especially. When we started looking at Kambi, one thing that was highly important for us to be able to actually create the best sports book was everything we did had to be scalable. If we want to fight with especially Bet365 back in the days, to create something that the B2C company could do, we had to do exactly the same thing for everyone. And we couldn't really have a solution where we had bespoke development for each and every operator. I think that's a very big part of a mantra to this day. We have added to that that we also understand that all operators have to be different and be their own brands. And I think when we talk about the product later on today, we will talk quite a lot about what we're doing to be able to differentiate as well. Just some pointers of where we are today. When we started Kambi, we were less than 80 people from Unibet transferring to Kambi. Now we are more than 700 people. I think a lot has happened. I think another really interesting figure is down there, the process. We could count the odds in hundreds of thousands back in 2009 when we did the B2B plan. Now we're doing roughly 480 million odds changes on a monthly basis. So we have 700 people. You clearly see that most of it is highly automated. We use the people to add some additional value to all the algorithms, but most of it is highly automated nowadays. We have customers in six continents. The seventh continent, I don't think will ever be regulated, Antarctica. But all in all, I would say that we have grown a lot. We're not a small company anymore. And I think after my presentation, Cecilia will talk more about that, how we are transforming from a small company to a large company. Little bit more about the industry we are in. You can hear a lot about spectator numbers are falling in sports. Yes, sure. But I don't think sports has been more popular ever than it is today. However, people are changing the way we are consuming sports. I think also broadcasters have problems because more and more of all the sports in the world are consumed on different types of streams. And you see big American sports like NFL, they are working with Twitter, for instance, to broadcast their matches. So I think you will see more and more change of how people are consuming sports and therefore being even more adaptable to sports betting. But don't for 1 second worry about that sports is not still massive interest across the globe. He has one to show this. It's actually roughly 3 years old now. This is a penalty in England, Iceland in Euros 3 years ago. I just want to show this because I think this is typically what we always trying to do. Trying to find ways of making sports betting as instant as possible. We never closed the offering for this penalty. With algorithms, it took us less than a second to be up and running with new prices. And as you will see, as soon as the goal is scored here, prices are changing and you can bet again. This was clearly not possible a few years ago. And I mean, we have gone quite far from what Lars was showing, where you had to post your bets 4 or 5 days in advance to actually being able to bet on something so instant as a penalty in football. So now I will hand over to Cecilia. But very much of the next bit will be about how we are transforming what we're doing at the moment to fit in to a much larger organization. Thank you.